And I also want to bring up the fact that I am about those who show action. You know, a lot of people do a lot of talking, but it's about action. And I can say about you, see, you don't know who's watching you, okay?
Right, that's right.
Now, Monica and I were in Annapolis earlier this year, and to get there, we came down to talk about the language in domestic violence, okay? Right. Not knowing that you were part of the process.
Right.
And it made me proud to say, not say my senator, but my brother was there to represent us as women.
Yes.
Because I thought we were going to have a woman to represent us because of domestic violence. But to get there to see a brother and to see you there made me proud. So I'm all about show me some action. When you do some action and make some moves and make things happen, then we can talk. We got a conversation. So I applaud you for that, number one. But go back and let's talk about your challenges that you have as being a senator in Annapolis.
Thank you very much. And let me, I don't want to waste time, but I want to say this in all humility. I don't make it a habit of trying to be negative and put people down. I put processes down. If processes don't work and it doesn't work, it just doesn't work. My greatest challenge in Annapolis has been our Democratic leadership. And our Democratic leadership, mostly white males, who are in positions of power and sometimes out of touch with this with what is happening in the real world. In the real world, we can sit down and we can be partners, whether you're white, black, whatever. But in the political world, it is this. You will either go along with us or we will punish you. And I don't take kindly to that because I've been through too much of my life for someone to threaten me and say, we're going to do this, we'll pull you off of this committee, we'll put you over here, we'll tell the press this. No, my issue is, first of all, I don't represent you. You never voted for me anyway. You don't even live in my district. I represent the people in my district.
That's right.
And that's who I'm going home and stand in front of. You can take me off of committees. You can talk about me. You cannot allow me to be involved in the process, but you can't stop me from being a senator. So my greatest thing has not even been my colleagues in Annapolis. All of my colleagues in Annapolis, with the exception of some in leadership position, all of my colleagues in Annapolis, be they Republican, Democrat, black, white, Jewish, male, female, have a great relationship with them. I've been able, in spite of leadership, to reach across the aisle, because you do what you have to do, and I've gotten 200 or 300 pieces of legislation passed into law, not because the leadership wanted me to, but because I had the relationship and they trusted me enough to say, we don't really care what they say, we're going to go along with you.
Exactly.
And so I've been able to do that. I've been able to get things done, get things passed. The other is because we sometimes have too few who understand who would understand what it's like to be poor and have nothing. And let me say this the right way. When you haven't had food to eat and you have to go through the day and figure out where you're going to get a meal, then you don't forget about that.
That's right.
I have people who make it look like people are looking for handouts. They're not looking for handouts. There's some things inherently wrong in this system that perpetuates for some to be people of no opportunity and no means. Those are the things we have to change. And when I go about trying to change that, I get really pushback, not from a whole lot of Republicans, I get it from a lot of Democrats. And you're my Democrat brother, you telling me you can't understand what's going on in our neighborhoods? And it's not always among our whites. It's sometimes it's our blacks who are leaders who are just so happy to be there and to have the position, they forget where they come from. That's been my struggle, but I'm thankful that I've been able to at least be as successful as I am. I've become county executive. I want to surround myself with people who understand what it's like to struggle and to make it and to be blessed and to have good policy and can help us forge the kind of government that makes it open for all.
Yes.
One thing I want to touch on is in politics, two things that you don't do is talk about religious, you know, spiritual belief or in politics. But and let's be real, let's address the ugly elephant about that. You know, because we have a lot of people that believe that pastors should not be into politics.
Right.
But I just want to know where that scripture in the Bible says that. You know, if somebody can point that one out to me, you know what I'm saying?
As a people have had people say things to us simply to divide us and dilute our vote.
Mm-hmm.
There is nowhere constitutionally nor biblically that says, as a pastor,
exactly,
I have a different standard than you as a deacon.
Right. Yes. Right.
So a deacon can get elected, but a pastor can't.
Yes.
And there
yes.
are no double standards. You got to live right, I got to live right, you got to
right.
do right, I got to do right. There's no such thing as doing right above doing right. Constitutionally, it is not correct, because the only thing the Constitution says is that Congress shall not impose a religion.
That's right.
I can never be Congress. Congress is consists of the House, the Senate, the
mm-hmm.
president signing a bill into law,
mm-hmm.
and the Supreme Court being able to interpret whether or not it was legal. Mm-hmm. So I can never violate separation of church and state, only Congress.
Oh, Congress.
And mm-hmm. the only way Congress can do it is to come up with a bill that says everybody will be will go to Mises Church. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
now you have imposed a religion, and now Congress must go through the process to see if that happens. And then when it comes to what has happened to us, in 1954, up until 1954, every church, everyone could participate in politics.
Mm-hmm.
But for the blacks, the church was the place,
the place.
That became a force.
Mm-hmm.
The
That's
church
right.
was where people could gather and be safe.
Mm-hmm.
And so prior to 1954, people got elected of color because the church got behind them.
Mm-hmm.
In 1954,
mm-hmm.
Lyndon
exactly.
Johnson, on a House amendment, put an amendment in that said those who are 501c3s, meaning those who
yeah.
have some tax, you know, wasn't just churches,
exactly.
but anyone with some tax exemption,
right.
mm-hmm.
cannot participate politically.
Right.
Because he had in Texas, when he was running for U.S. Senate, Lyndon B. Johnson had 501c3s who were coming against him in big numbers, so he passed this amendment that said you can't speak out politically. Then we started telling people that there's a separation of church and state. And people have heard it so much that they just repeat it without even knowing what they're saying.
Right.
If you
exactly.
ask them to repeat
right.
it, they can't tell it.
Right.
If anything,
right.
I am a citizen of this United States of America. As long as they're taking my tax money, I will participate in this process to whatever capacity where people raises me. And we've got to stop repeating stuff that we hear, because people want, they know that many people are not going to read, they're not
mm-hmm.
going to study.
They're not
so
going to
they
research.
They walk around
right.
with you pastor, separation
mm-hmm.
church and state. Ain't no separation of church and state. My license to be a preacher comes from the state.
That's right.
Right.
If the state doesn't okay me, I can't marry somebody in the state.
Thank
so there's no separation.
Mm-hmm.
And then they take my tax money too anyway.
No. I like the fact, and I like the fact that you're saying that it's not politics for you. It's a purpose.
That's right.
You know.
Right.
So, and that's the other part I want to talk about. That you know, it's just you and a few out here that make it a known fact that everything that you do is coming from God. You know, because if you stay in the will of God, God have a purpose
right.
and a calling for all of us,
that's
and
right.
you're moving in His purpose. And you, I like the fact that on your trail, you let everyone know what's most important
right.
and where you get your blessings from.
That's
and,
right.
you know, because sometimes we start moving and we start thinking, like you said, we get in these positions, start thinking it's a given, and we
right.
forget how we get there.
That's
it's
right.
a blessing to be there. It's not a given. It's a blessing.
That's
it's,
right.
you know, and it's God's purpose for your life and for your calling. So why is it important that you stay true to your faith and your
That's
belief
right.
while you're on this journey?
From a constitutional perspective, we talk about freedom of religion, and then and we talk about freedom to not suppress one's religion. And then on the other hand, we say, but you can't talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
I often approach it from pragmatically, and I say to people, if my being who I am, I'm a Christian, that's who I am. And if that bothers you, why does it bother you? And they say, because I'm not a believer.
Mm-hmm.
I say, well,
mm-hmm.
if you're not a believer, what if I said I worship Peter Pan? If I said I worship Peter Pan, you're going to laugh at me.
Yeah.
And you're not going to get mad at me.
Right.
You're
going to
say, he's crazy. Well, if you don't believe in who I serve,
that's
great. But why should it make you angry if you don't think he exists anyway?
That's right.
Like,
exactly.
just get along.
That's right.
I'm going to appreciate
it.
His
yeah.
point that you don't believe, appreciate what I believe, but let's not move freedom of speech or freedom of belief. That's from the constitutional side. From my biblical side, I choose to be who I am. And I choose to say that I have the evidence of that of who I serve because of where I come from, and that's who I believed in, who got me this far. That you may believe Allah may have gotten you as far as you are, and Buddha may have gotten you as far as you are, but for me, it was the Lord Jesus Christ who got me to where I am. I believe that. I'm not ashamed of that. And in America, I shouldn't be ashamed of that. Amen. If Peter Pan does not exist, he doesn't exist. Why get angry?
That's right.
All right. Monica, so
yeah. Yeah. One of the things that you said, Senator Muse, that just resonated on what we do, just one of some of the programs that we have at Sisters for Sisters Network, not endorsing anything, but just telling you who we are. Mm-hmm. When you said about the lunchroom workers,
that's correct.
So the lunchroom workers dictate, well, not them, but their hourly rate wages dictate when these kids eat. Mm-hmm.
That's correct.
Okay.
That's
so correct. When you are in the fifth grade and lunch is at 10 o'clock in the morning.
That's right.
For some of these kids, that's their last meal for the day.
That is correct.
So mentally, how can you be ready for school? If your last meal of the day is at 10:45 in the morning.
And some of them don't even get that meal in the morning before 10 o'clock.
Until you get back to school the next day, to get another free meal.
Yep.
Because the workers make $10 an hour and they have to be out of the school by 2 o'clock.
That's right.
Crazy.
So that they don't pay overtime.
That's right.
Crazy.
Wow.
So you don't eat. We as us are trying to work with Share and Catholic Charities.
Mm-hmm.
My position on the Maryland State PTA Executive Board is to talk to every PTA president to get them to incorporate Share as a fundraiser so that people like us can support it and pay $21 for a Share package.
Tell what Share is.
So Share is a food program that you buy great produce, fresh foods, for $21. So I want to add $2 to the Share and make it a fundraiser.
Okay.
People are embarrassed about Share.
Wow.
So they don't go to get it. I'm talking about poor
people.
Yeah,
because there's a reason.
It's a reason, okay? But if we bring it into the school as a fundraiser through the state, through the PTAs, because we as PTAs and PTSAs are nonprofit organizations, and we can do that. Make it a fundraiser, add $2 more a month on it.
Mm-hmm.
You get enough food to feed a family of four or five.
That's right.
There will be no separation because the school will be doing it as a whole, as a fundraiser.
Correct.
We're already committed to buy packages to give away to families who can't afford to buy them. But 10 o'clock in the morning, you get your last meal.
And I hear what they say about that, and I think it's because it takes time and effort to go back and say, something isn't working, let's redo it.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Exactly.
We have over 700,000 children in Maryland who are on what we call free and reduced lunch.
Mm-hmm.
If that is what is happening, then why is it that we are turning down programs that are trying to help us?
Right.
And I'll give you a case in point. You talk about your program. As the county, we don't even have a grants writing office. Do you know how much money is out here?
Well, we know.
We don't
no,
have
we
a
know.
Grants writing
we're going
office.
After
how do you not have a grants writing office? How do you not deal with persons who have programs at work? Because if you really care about kids who are hungry, you wouldn't let money that we can get just fall by the wayside.
Exactly.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
And in so many areas, not just in the areas of lunch and food, but in the area of affordable housing,
yes,
we let millions of dollars go by the wayside because it doesn't benefit some to have affordable housing in the county.
That's
because
right.
The land then isn't as worth as much to the developers who are trying to make all the money off of the land by pushing some people out and letting other people in. Now, that's not popular, but I've been around long enough to know that it is true. You got to have a heart for these kids.
That's right.
To say whatever's going to work. We are spending billions of dollars. You better find a way to make it work. You better find a way to say that we're not going to be the kind of state that will give away. And I say this on not because of a person, but because of the audacity. You know, I can never defend $1 million sign just to sign your name to get $1 million. Mm-hmm. You know what that money could have done in a school? The reason they keep they do that 2 o'clock rule is because they know that if they go beyond that, they got to pay what?
Overtime.
Or maybe even benefits. So they most of my cafeteria workers and others, as large as they are, they don't have benefits. They don't have health insurance.
That's right.
How do we look ourselves in the face at the end of the day and say we gave all this other money away, but we've got people working, you know, all these hours, and we're not going to give them any kind of retirement. We're not going to give them any kind of health care. If we're going to tell other businesses what to do, then charity begins at home.
That's right.
We're going to do it with our workers and our state and our county government and our school board. We're going to go back and reevaluate how we're doing that. And don't tell me we have a money problem. We have a money wasting problem and a money rewarding to the wrong programs problem, but we don't have a money problem. I want to look at that program. We want to look at programs like that because there's so much to go around. No one can handle all of it.
Exactly.
But we got to look at that and make it work.
That's right.
Yes. And I know we got to wrap it up, and let's wrap it up on this note, educating the people. We need to get our people educated, because when it's midterm election, we don't come out and vote. If it's not the presidential election, we don't come out and vote. Here in Prince George's County, we only had 34% to come out at the last midterm, and out of that 34%, 65% of that was women. So we have to educate people and let them know why it's important, because when it comes to our local politics, if we don't get involved, then we get what we get.
That is right.
Exactly.
So then when you get involved, and my thing is, let your vote be your voice.
That's right.
Because if you don't vote, then you lost your voice. You know, so we need to educate them. And also in your position, because when you was running for Senate, you had 9 cities in your district. But now that your county is at, it's countywide. So we need to educate people that and let them know, because now you got to cover countywide. That means, you know, after the primaries, you got to hit over 200, the voting
pool. 27 municipalities and cities, and I want to know about every one of them. I'm meeting with all the mayors, and I'm getting to walk to areas, know beyond where I'm represented, and they have been very accommodating to make that happen. And I've been more and more aware of the fact that, yes, we have a diverse county, but we have enough resources in every way to make it work.
Yes.
Everybody is invited here. Everybody's invited to a seat at the table, because the table is so vast, because the resources are so vast that we can make it work. That's all I want to do.
All right. So, June, we need you guys. We need to know this. The early voting starts June 14th through the 21st in 2018, and then the actual primary day is June the 26th. We need you to get out there, get voting, and if they want to get involved with your campaign, give us the information.
That's right. I would like to see them get involved with our campaign. I'm really going to say that. I'm going to say I'd like to see them get involved with our campaign. If they could do that, that will be extremely helpful. I have I'm going to give out all of the websites that we have here.
Mm-hmm. And while you look for that,
have the volunteers.
That go your sweet daughter that got me this appointment. How are you doing, sweetheart?
There we go. There's a phone number, if I may.
You can give all the information.
And it is the best way to reach us and reach out to us. If you want to know more about us, have information that you want to say to us, you can give us a call on 240-302-8821. That is 240-302-8821. You can also visit us and contact us directly at our campaign office. If you really want to know information about our campaign office, you can reach us on www.museforprincegeorges.com. That's www.museforprincegeorges.com. If I may, and if you're already out there writing, just continue to write. I have one other campaign number, and it's 301-459-0805. 301 1-800-459-0805. I hope you will contact us at least to learn some information so that if you vote for me, you know why. If you don't, at least you'll know why. But at least get the information.
Yes, I love it. I love it. So, give the mic to one of the, so why are you volunteering with Muse? Somebody, answer the question. Why are you part of the team?
Yes, my name is Dr. Vincent Dagaboku. I'm volunteering. I've been living in PG County for the past nearly 30 days. This is a man who is going to touch everybody. I'm from Nigeria originally. Yes. We are mobilizing for everybody to vote for him. He's a good man.
Yes.
That's why I'm supporting him.
Yes.
And he's going to win.
All right. Yes, yes.
Hi, I'm Tara Maxwell. First, I work for the Sheriff's Office, and Senator Muse is very supportive of domestic violence in the county. I worked in the 26th District in Annapolis with Senator Muse. I have graduated from being a semi-supporter to a diehard supporter.
I love that. Right? Wait a minute, a semi-supporter to a diehard supporter. That's good.
We need change. We need change, and he represents that change, and we have to get rid of the machine.
Yes, I love it.
That's my other girlfriend right here.
Yes, my name is Jewel Dozier, and I was the labor relations specialist for the Ask Me Locals in Prince George's County. And I work with the administration to get good contracts and so forth, whatever. Not that we always got them, because we haven't got one lately. But moving on, I retired 6 months ago. I have been with the senator. I don't think nothing brought us together. But God.
Oh, wow. Say that again.
But God.
Amen.
So I've been with him for many years. I'm in this for the win. He is going to win. We have predicted. I believe that God introduced me to Muse because he is a man united to serve all people.
Yes, sister. Go ahead on, sister. I love it. Woo-wee. You got some diehards for you right here. Nothing but God.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jacqueline Childs Coates, and I wanted to volunteer because I knew about the senator. And then I had a conversation with him. He probably doesn't remember this, but I had a conversation with him, and he told me what his mentor said, and he said that he had to take care of the people. And I believed him. I think I have the spirit of discernment, and I believe him. I think he's a good man, and he wants us to hold him accountable, and we're going to hold him accountable.
Oh, wow. That is wonderful.
Excellent.
Yes.
We're going to get everybody.
Yes.
And
well, I'm going to talk for you. So you want me to talk for you or you want to do it for yourself?
Okay. I am I'm from Cameroon originally. I am supporting the senator because he has a record. He is someone who doesn't listen or take orders from the party bosses. He is his own man. And he's for the people. So that's why I'm supporting him.
Awesome.
Yes.
Thank
yes.
Thank you so much.
And I'm going to go ahead and speak for his lovely daughter, Keontae, over there. I love her. And, she's very shy. But you know what? But if you get her talking about her father, she's not shy anymore. Because when I called, I'm going to tell you, your team is so professional. The customer service is there.
Yes.
You know, and I'm not saying this because a daughter. I'm saying it now on a professional business level. She was very thorough, very professional. She was like, Karen, I'm going to take down these dates and I'm going to call you right back. Within 15 minutes, she called back. We confirmed it up and she was like, okay. And then she called again and just wanted to check everything out. And when I saw her Monday, she was like, Karen, oh, you're the one. Yeah, you even did. So, you know, she gave me lots of her. So I'm going to steal a her when we go on commercial break. So she's very, you know, so I want to be able to say that on the record that, you have a beautiful team here and you're raising a wonderful daughter. And I must say, and your wife, we love her too because domestic violence is yours and caregiving month is hers.
Yes, it is.
Yes, in November. I had the pleasure of interviewing her last year.
Yes.
She was at Patricia Morris event. And she told her story. And I like the fact that you guys are authentic.
You are authentic and you're personable
with the community that you serve. So that's going to take you far, Senator. And I will say
Thank
that God see that. And he always rewards the ones with what the authentic heart. So
yeah.
So if I can say that, and
I see that.
Yes, I hope you do really receive that. And what I want to say, too, is that we want to, on October the 14th, we are trying to get all pastors to come together and open their minds and let them recognize how important, like you said, because it started in the church for the black people.
That's right.
You know, that was our way of getting
that's
things
right.
done. So I would love to offer the opportunity for you to come out and all the pastors. We're going to, matter of fact, when I leave here, I'm going to look at Butler's Farm. We because he's black owned and they trying to run him out of there because you know with having
land.
That land
wow,
they
yeah.
find
yeah.
Yes. yes 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 so and we want to go and support him and bring all the pastors down where we can just you know just educate ourselves and go back to how it originally started and that is the churches coming together and the
yes.
community coming
yes.
together
yes.
and we're putting these people in places and giving them the opportunity because for me that's what the difference is going to make or we going to end up what we got now
right.
if we stop being quiet and not using our
that's
votes
right.
and letting it be
and
our voice
and
when the power
right.
we have we got to get behind we're going to start making a change and choose because your choice have actions
yes.
you know and
right.
choose the ones that we want in the house
mm-hmm.
you know and stop failing at that because we had too many of our ancestors that fought so hard mm-hmm. for us to have this opportunity to vote and we need to get together and get back on top of it so when I hear that the voting is down 34% we only had 34%. That's sad to me when I see Solomon how they had to fight and the struggle was so hard for us to get that opportunity. So I want to start where I know I'm from the South, as you can hear. I want to start back at how we did it, and that
that's
was
right.
in
it
the church.
Was the church.
It
was.
Was the church. So
yes.
I'm glad to hear you say that. So I would definitely keep you posted through that lovely one
that.
Over there.
Yes,
and below, off the record, sit down and have a meeting with you before we come up on October the 14th. That's what we're doing. We're calling all pastors, and let's take over this thing
right.
and get you there.
Absolutely.
And we need to get you there. And the pastors don't have to be in Prince George's
yeah.
County.
Yeah.
We're
right.
calling from all over because I'm glad
right.
you said that you're meeting with pastors that's mm-hmm. from Kenyon and all that because we have one on our show. He just couldn't be here today, an
yes,
apostle, and he's
yes.
from Panama.
Yes.
So he do the Spanish segment on our show for
yes.
us,
yes.
you know, and we call it the Renew Man Hour,
mm-hmm.
you know, and because we got to be able to talk about our spiritual belief, our faith. So
Without
I was so glad you was here today and it's about Faith Week this week, you know, because your faith is everything because without faith, you know.
You have nothing.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay. All right. So, you know, and we know that, right? So we
right.
got to trust in the Lord
and
with all our heart.
Right.
Lead not
right.
to our own understanding. Acknowledge him in all our ways. And he
yeah.
will continue to
direct
our path. You know all of it. Yes, yes, yes.
Let me say this. You know, you really don't know how your path is going to cross. Because we crossed many years ago. Number one, we have in common is that we're Morganites.
Oh, yes, yeah.
Class
yeah,
of 77
yeah,
for
yeah.
me.
Okay? Yeah, okay, yeah.
And when I moved to Prince George's County, my love and passion is photography. That's what I do besides everything else.
That's right.
Because it's important for me to document history.
Mm-hmm.
This is history that's happening
that's
right here in this room.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
But one thing, I don't think you remember the fact that I photographed your opening of your church.
With
Lamar.
Wow.
With Lamar. That's right. You did.
Okay.
Lamar Fund.
So see
her,
how
right.
see how our path had crossed?
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Mm-hmm. You know, you got to treat people right the
first
time.
Because yeah. you never know.
Because
you
yeah.
never
yeah.
know. When you're gonna, you never know. And that's one thing I was always taught. And that's one thing I say to our staff. That's one thing Brandy and Keontae, knowing them since they were born, they are my adopted children.
Mm-hmm.
And the spirit is what makes you one. And I say to them, and our volunteers, treat people right.
Mm-hmm.
Be kind to people.
Exactly.
Even if they're wrong,
yes.
you can be kind to them because you're here to serve
that's
them.
It.
And that's what matters because you never know whose path you're going to come across again,
wow.
who will be in a position to help you. And then you act if you act arrogant and
mm-hmm.
nasty,
and people don't forget.
Then it means you have forgotten where you come
that's
from.
Right.
Because no position of power makes one or drives one to the point where he or she thinks they're better than another. We are servants to the people,
right.
and we're supposed to just be kind to them, and I believe that.
Oh, right.
And then that goes into
the same thing that you're saying, love covers a multitude of sin.
Yes, yes. And on that note, we're going to let your daughter, look, your daughter doing her job, okay? She gave me the cue. She like, Karen, we got to wrap it up. Uh-huh, Keontae. Am I representing you well over here, girl?
Better than what they do to me on Sundays, you know, like.
Look,
I just want to say
to all the ladies out there, if you would go to Facebook and hashtag I am a woman for C. Anthony Muse.
Yes. I am a woman for C. Anthony Muse. Yes, and Keontae, I would get in touch with you later on today and give you the link to the show. Last words.
I just appreciate your kindness. I appreciate your openness to our vision. I appreciate those as we moved around this county who've been open to our vision, open to what we're saying, and they're saying we want change and we want people who care about us in those positions. I thank you all. I won't let you down. I want to work as hard as I can to make this a reality. God bless you and God bless our county. Thank you so much.
All right. You heard it here on eLife Media. We'll be right back at you. Yes, this is great. Ooh, thank you. Something.
Oh, reaching out, touching me, touching you.
Okay, guys.
All right. Well, okay, we back. Welcome back. Wow. Welcome back to E-Life Media's Sister Line Talk. Oh, that was a good one.
That was really good.
Peggy, Charlie.
In the house.
That's all I can say. I can say Charlie in the building. Oh, that God. Was a great segment. I mean, awesome. Just the last 2 we have an Angela Austinberg on.
And now
I was having Senator Muse on, you know. And my thing is just let them all come in and you know, have the voice. Let them be the voice here.
We forgot to invite him to the prayer feast tomorrow. So
there you go. Somebody go catch him and let him know. Yeah. Yes, and tell him on the house.
You told him that
Ingrid
was going to come in. He was ready to bring it down. So we got.
I like that. You see how the whole time he was taking his notes and. And he's a really good person, you know. And I have to say, I had a good time with Andrea, too. She's really a good person, too. So it's just like, you know, so, it's, you know, but I would say they both are, you know, just always
awesome
doing awesome things in the
right.
community.
Yes.
And either way, they're going to continue to succeed at what they're doing.
Right. Exactly.
So, daughter is going to text you. To get the information.
Okay.
And he was like, yeah, because I want some food.
So I got to text her and see that's the link. I got in good with the daughter because I know she's
always the way in.
That's right, and that's right. And you know, and that was the key to with Willie Jolly too. I remember meeting Willie Jolly, and to this day I still don't want his personal number. I call Mrs. D because if it's gonna happen, that's how it's gonna happen. You gotta go through Mrs. D.
That's right.
And I've been, what, Peggy, we've been knowing them for years now. And Peggy, well, I always call Mrs. Dean. When she said, Karen, we need to get in touch with Willie and let him know we're doing S, Y, and Z. I said, okay, I'll call Mrs. D.
That's right, Karen.
Yeah, because Dean's the one that's going to make it happen, mm-hmm. okay?
That's right.
Mm-hmm. What did we say today? We women do what? We make it happen.
We make it happen.
Hey, you hear that, Ron? We women make it happen.
They
do. I engineer over there like, Well, I want to say Class Act is making it happen on this coming Friday the 22nd. And wow. I must share that I am just so proud to be celebrating 5 years of the vision experience.
Yes,
and this is going to talk about my faith. You know, I always have to fast and pray for myself at the beginning of the year for God, you know, because it's great when you're doing it with the church or you're in church, but, you know, just having that intimate experience for yourself. And he just gave me this. And I remember my very first one, I called all the people together. You remember that, Peggy? And I was like, God put this on my heart. I don't know how it's going to come to. And this is going to be a process that, you know, domestic violence and mental health care is going to be the two that I'm going to center on and focus on. And it's going to be it, whether I have to help someone else. And now even knowing Peggy's story at the time. So that day was the first time Peggy shared her story with me at my house. Mm-hmm. You remember? So that's why I say this one, the Vision Conference, I keep it private. You know, New Year's Day, we family it and all this, but a vision conference had to be private because that's how it started out. Started out about faith, and I didn't know what to call it. So then that was just a call of women that I had. And then the next time, but God was just like, no, you need to not only just be women, you need to open it up and bring all people together.
Yeah. And that's when Dr. Doolittle was there.
Mm-hmm. And that's when I was like, okay. And then it started out as a fundraiser for the youth awards that I was doing. Mm-hmm. And I said, I'm going to do this as a fundraiser. And it went over so well, Monica, that everybody was like, Karen, you got to do this every year. So every year, September, I opened up my home. So everybody know I always take the last week, well, the last to the last, because this year had 5 weeks in it. Right. So I always say like the third, and this year is going to be the fourth week in September. And I opened up my home and I had the vision conference because I couldn't let it go after that one time. It was so wonderful of experience. So now this would be the last year, though, it would be in my home because we're taking it on the road.
Yes.
And I'm going to tell you how God worked, that we already are booked for next year. It's going to be September the 29th. We are going to start doing the last week in September. So September the 29th, 2018, we at Newton White Mansion that Saturday all day.
Excellent.
And let me tell you how God worked. We already booked for September 2019 in Atlanta.
So that means we
got to
travel with you, right?
And we are part of the seven masterminds.
That's right.
And Monica just came up and said, Karen, I want to coordinate. I want to be the coordinator of the event.
I did.
And I want you to speak at my event. I was like, God, you are just awesome. So she was getting ready to go. I said, no, Monica. Because I wanted, you know, one thing about it, when God bless you with something, you know, you have to realize where your blessing comes from. So I wanted to thank you on the air, Monica. She came with a pure heart. And that's just how we are in our mastermind classes.
We
just want to inspire each other and motivate each other. And whatever we can do to help that person get to that lesson, you know, that level that they want to be at, that's what we do. And that's the lesson learned for that day, you know. And I can say it started out by us just helping John, playing him an event.
Yes.
And now the event came and gone. And now we still getting together once a month.
Yeah.
To still encourage each other.
Yes.
It is so awesome.
Yes.
It's so awesome how we do measurable things.
colleagues.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
We
sure
keep
do.
Each other accountable yes. for sure. that which God has entrusted us with.
Yes.
And that is
yes.
awesome.
Been amazing. And I like it because John makes sure each month that yes. somebody go get in the hot
yes.
chair.
Yes.
Yeah, the hot yes. seat. So it was Peggy the first time, and then John was just in it himself.
Yes. Right, right.
So I'm like, oh, Lord, who going to be next? And when you're in that hot seat, it just come at you, too.
It's hot.
Yeah.
And
yes.
that's awesome.
Yeah.
And it's
yeah.
accountability. Yeah. It makes all of us yes. accountable for what
right.
we're doing. Mm-hmm. So.
It yes. makes you accountable for that which you have already said
yes.
God has called you to do.
To do
and that's what we love the most.
Mm-hmm.
And you can feel the passion.
Mm-hmm.
You can feel mm-hmm. the purpose.
I feel it right
each
now.
Each meeting
I'm not
that
gonna
we
lie,
do.
You guys. I feel it right now. Uh-huh. And I remember when I met Karen. I met Karen at her house on New Year's Day. Oh my God. Okay.
Yes.
And on New Year's Day, you're normally recovering from the night before or cooking dinner for your family. I had my shoes off, socks on at Karen's house.
Yes, and we
yes.
had an amazing time.
So
thank
I can
you, Monica.
Only imagine with or without me the magnitude in which your conference is going to touch the lives of others.
Absolutely. Oh,
thank you. Thank you.
Everything
New
we
Year's
touched
Day.
Turned to gold.
It does.
Gold.
Yes. Yes.
You know,
it's
you
been
danced
amazing.
Last weekend.
Yes.
And when I tell you, it touched the people behind the stage
mm-hmm.
who watched you
mm-hmm.
from the back of the stage because
oh.
we were behind and you touched us. There was tears streaming
mm.
because
wow.
you're so good at what you do. But you don't take the credit. You give the credit where the credit is due.
Mm-hmm.
And that is God.
God
has ordained you
oh,
to
wow.
do what you do.
Yeah.
And
wow.
share with the audience what happened.
Yes.
Tell them about the play. Y'all two. I mean,
you know,
I was there Friday
I just
night.
I say, every time I hear that melody and that song,
yeah, rise
I think of you. Every time.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Every time. And
absolutely.
Sometimes
I have
just
to say
that's our theme
spirit.
Song.
Yes.
Yeah.
It has
my
resonated
we can,
with
us. We
audience, I'm jealous.
Year.
Audience, I'm jealous. I could not be there, audience.
I was there Friday
but
night.
I'm jealous.
But I have to tell you, Monica, I have to tell you this. You got a touch of it.
Mm-hmm.
On New Year's.
Yes, I did it in my house.
Okay, I take that back. So you were still blessed.
All right.
You still
all
got
right.
to receive it.
And a blessing
it
was.
Awesome.
And a blessing it was.
It was absolutely awesome.
Yeah.
So the game changer, the play,
absolutely phenomenal.
Yes.
That's all I can say.
Yes.
I thoroughly enjoyed. I don't know what I anticipated.
Margaret.
But when I said
she
there,
be at the craft feast tomorrow.
Yeah,
she was here last weekend.
Margaret did a phenomenal job on that play.
Yes,
the play was hilarious. I didn't just say funny.
Mm-hmm.
I said hilarious.
Yes.
And it was
absolutely.
Good because it captured the
in.
Audience.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. And it also
delivered
gave
message.
The message.
Yeah.
And when the message was given, it was point taken, silence, and heard.
Mm-hmm. Thank
you,
Monica.
Bye, Monica.
Bye-bye, Monica. Bye. She's going to be traveling with the play. I believe the next play is going to be in New York. I told her that I would be there to support her.
Mm-hmm.
If we could all get a bus. People
Let's
like
go.
To go to New York to go shopping.
Mm-hmm.
We go shopping during
and
the day,
support.
Hit the play at night.
Mm-hmm.
And let's support her because it's great.
Yeah,
and
so
I'm telling you, it's funny how you meet people and that you're going to keep in your network base. It was at a mix and mingle that I met her.
Really?
Yes, yes.
But check this out. She came to the office on, I think, Thursday, Friday, and stopped by, and Nina met her at the door. So she comes and sit down and talk. Found out that we knew each other from the county.
Yes.
I kept saying, I know her face, I know her face. When she got up on the stage that night, I kept saying, I know that face, but I couldn't figure out where it was.
Mm-hmm.
She came to the office, we got to talking, and that was history. We
y'all
each
worked
other
at
the
county.
It was so awesome because I got to meet my girlfriend who I have not seen since elementary. She sang in the play.
Really?
And I got to see her entire family, which was my family, growing up. It was amazing how God will bring people into your lives because when I walked in the backstage and I saw Tracy, and I got to say, Tracy, and she immediately embraced me. It was
but you know,
awesome.
It's all about when I tell y'all guys about showing up.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing things happen when you show up.
Yes.
You just have to show us.
I cannot express my feelings. Sometimes there are times when I'm just so exhausted and the Lord, he pushes me. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, why are you pushing me? Mm-hmm. And yeah. I get myself together and I show up and I'm like, if I had not shown up, see who I would have missed, mm-hmm. a missed opportunity. Mm-hmm. It just takes me back. So when that happens and he pushes me, I get up and go.
Exactly.
Because something is about to happen.
And, you know, and that is true because, you know, when you're going on all cylinders all the time, you know, 7 days a week, you know, we all have something to do. So my thing I have said this year, y'all heard me say it on a radio mm-hmm. show, that I'm going to stop saying, I'm busy.
Right,
because
right.
who not? Right. We all
exactly.
can claim that.
Exactly.
We all, if you're doing something productive, want to be productive, then you are staying busy.
Exactly.
So
exactly.
I don't say that word anymore because you know what? You can make time
for
what it is that you want to do. Yes, that's what you want to make time for. And so you're right, Peggy. So when I do make the extra effort to go to certain things and support it, even though I may be just worn mm-hmm. and I stop saying tired,
right.
even though I may have a full day,
right.
started
exactly.
busy, you know, I'm making sure that I go the extra mile for those who I connect with and we affect. Because like you said, you never know, you know, what's going to come from that. And you always, when you do that and you go out your way for others, the blessing always come back. You thinking you going there
so
to bless
awesome.
Them.
It is so
and
good.
You are really
you
getting the
blessed.
You're
exactly.
really
that
getting the
blessing.
That
is how me and Miss Peggy met. Just yeah. doing that, she was being honored.
That's right.
And she was up on the stage, and I kept looking at her. I said, I have to connect with her. Well, everything went on, but it was at the end of it. I pulled her, and she was getting ready to walk out the door, and I said, I just got to meet you. I don't know what
and
it
I'm
is.
Like, huh,
my
me?
Spirit is gravitating towards you.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what
and
it's
that's
about
how we
you.
Connected.
Mm-hmm. And I have been connected to this woman ever since. And
that's
it has
right.
been such an honor to awesome to just serve with you.
No, y'all guys don't have no clue what you do for me. Mm-hmm. You know, I can't do all. I try many times, try to do a whole lot of stuff, okay? Mm-hmm. But for y'all guys to come in and bring in your vision,
mm-hmm.
and we can just pour it into one,
mm-hmm. yes,
okay, and then we can give it out to the masses. It brings so much joy to me.
Right. Heaven's yes. plate wouldn't be where it is today if it was not for Miss Peggy and the doors that she has began to help me walk through. Not just open, but walk through.
Well, Nina, I would have to say, too, you know, in this organization, we see a lot of women come and go, and we, you know, and we connect with. And Nina, I would say, Nina, I felt your dedication of you going to come in, and I hope you all remember this. When I first met Nina, come on now, you know where I'm going to go with
go
this
ahead.
Story because we're going to tell this story.
I remember.
When I first met Nina, you all had just did a walk, and we was at another location.
That's right.
Out of Greenbelt.
That's right.
Okay? And you was coming through real quick. You said, Karen, I'm going to do this walk. I may have to come on last in, but I'm going to make it there.
That's right.
And you brought Nina and Candace.
Yes, with you.
Right.
And we were supposed to be talking about the turkey drive.
Right.
The Spirit of God came up in that room.
Yes, it
we
did.
Was crying. We was shouting tears of joy,
yeah.
tears of.
Oh,
we was
God,
just. I was like. We even had the police officer up in there crying.
Yes,
you
everybody.
Remember that,
yes,
Officer Soto?
I
and I was like, and I saw the passion that you had about the domestic violence piece, and I was like, there you go for Peggy. And then not even knowing that I had called Peggy to my house.
That's right.
Prior to the year before, and we was talking about this thing, and I said, God said, be patient. Mm-hmm. He haven't revealed everything yet. And look how it's developing now, Peggy.
Unbelievable.
You know? Unbelievable. So I stay connected to Nina, and now me and Nina don't have to talk every
that's
day
right.
and all the mm-hmm. time. But when we do, it's
yes.
just like,
that's
my
true.
Sister.
That's
you
so
know,
true.
That is my sister. Am I lying,
no,
Nina?
No, we're not. No, we're not.
And that day was so special, wasn't it, Peggy?
It was.
And you know what, Karen? I'm telling you, I love y'all so much. And Peggy,
I have to bring it back to you, because if it wasn't what you have inside of you for us, mm-hmm. then when you meet one of us and you don't hear from us, you reach out to us. If we got other life situations going on, you come out there after us, and we have no other choice but to support you.
But y'all got to do the same for me. If I'm not there, you know something is wrong. Okay.
That's right.
And so what
are
y'all guys? Y'all guys come and chuckle
on
me.
Yeah, we're pegging. Hey, you ain't
that's
called
right.
me lately. What's
that's
going
right.
on?
What's the deal?
That's right.
What are you doing?
I'm telling you, I would just drive by and leave something on her
oh
porch.
My God.
And just
yes,
text her and say, just check your porch. Mm-hmm. And no need to respond. And just want you to know, just check your porch. And that's what you do when you love
and
each other.
And that's sisterhood.
That's what this is all about.
I love that. That's sisterhood. That's true sisterhood. Yes, yeah. And you know, because we're going to be in the clenches for each other. And we get on each other when it's needed too,
right.
You know?
Yeah, we do.
So, but it's all out of love. And I love you. I love my organization so much. You hear me saying my organization so much? Oh, hi. Because
yes.
I will be at the craft feast with my sister, Stamai.
But just all right. Enough for me and feel sorry for me because I can't come. I'm allergic.
Oh,
I make sure I
but
eat
I
enough for you.
And I made sure that the organization was still taken care of. I did my part for my sisterhood. I made sure that
we do
had
have barbecue. Can't you eat barbecue?
Yeah,
but just being around.
Yeah.
You don't want to be itching.
Yes, I'm real sensitive.
Yes, yes.
But you know what? I love you guys.
We love you back. Thank you for your support.
Yes. So we having our craft feast at the
Maltons. Can you stand outside the gate?
Yes. I'm going to come and wave to you guys.
Yes.
And be like, hey.
No, you can be the valet. You can be the valet and say, park here.
Park here.
Park there.
Yeah. Come out and see you.
We'll check on you.
Yeah.
Well, we will be at the Maltons tomorrow from 3 to 6.
3 to 6 p.m.
Yes, and that's in Upper Marlboro,
it's
Maryland.
It's our second annual craft feast and barbecue. And for those who are unaware, last year was amazing.
Yes, it was.
Karen,
okay.
You
it was
did
so,
it, girl.
It was
y'all gonna make me stop by, get a plate, and then leave before everything gets started.
Oh, yes.
Because I'm just not going to let y'all have that much fun with
me.
We had a good time, and it's always great. I just love it. And we also know, we can announce now that we will be at the Maltons again next year.
Yes.
So. So we already have the booking. We just got to finalize the date. It's going to either be the 9th or the 10th.
Uh-huh.
So Peggy is letting me know once we get off the air. So, just want to be able to do my part. So we have the Maltons again.
All right.
Well, let's take a moment to thank our engineer that came in to support us.
Yes!
Thank you so much.
Yes,
we appreciate you.
Yes, and we always pray off air. Nina, you want to take us out?
Oh, sure.
Because I know, yes.
Father God, we thank you, dear Lord, for this union and everyone that you have here together, oh God. We thank you for what you've done today, oh God. We thank you for bringing a man of God in to be able to come in and want to run Prince George's County, God.
Yes.
We believe your vision for him, oh God. Father, the same vision that you have for him, as we come together, as we speak on the air, oh God, we know and believe that you are guiding us and that everything that we're doing is unto your glory, oh God.
Yes.
And we're just
Jesus.
The tools providing what it is you need. Father God, we ask that you continue to give us safe travel and mercies as we get through this day, this weekend, and always. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Yes. And also, we want to give special prayers to Roland Grimes, who is an engineer here. He's going through a family emergency. So, Roland, you know, that's my studio husband. So,
right.
I want you guys to know you better pray for my studio husband.
That's
and I want him to know I love him so much.
I love you.
I know he peeped through just to make sure we's all right, because that's just
the
stand-up
the
guy
he is.
Now, he's having a family emergency, but he came through the studio to make sure that we was okay. So, I want to say on the air, that's my studio husband. Okay.
Thank you, Roland.
And Roland Grimes, I love you, man, and we're praying for you. Mwah.
Love you, love
now
you.
Now we done.
Until the next time.
Stay tuned. Yeah, stay blessed. And you're here.
All right.
For Sister Live Talk on eLife Media. See you next time.